Professor Dave again, let's look at some more lines.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We know how to graph lines in a few different forms, so let's start comparing different types of lines to see what we can learn from this. First, let's take a look at a graph containing two parallel lines. These are lines in the same plane that never intersect. In order for this to be the case, the lines must have the same ratio of vertical change to horizontal change. In other words, they must have equivalent slopes. Their equations will be different, but their slopes are identical. On the other hand, two lines that intersect at a right angle are perpendicular to one another. The relationship between the slopes of perpendicular lines is not as obvious as it was for parallel lines, but as it turns out, perpendicular lines have slopes that are opposite reciprocals of one another. By opposite reciprocal, we mean that if one has a slope of 2, the other has a slope of negative 1/2. If one has a slope of negative 5, the other has a slope of 1/5. We flip the term and flip the sign. There are many questions you may encounter in algebra that require you to understand these concepts. For example, a question may ask you to write the equation of any line that is perpendicular to y equals negative 1/4 x plus 2. If you are unaware of the relationship between the slopes of perpendicular lines, you might find yourself graphing this line and then choosing an arbitrary perpendicular line so you can find its equation. But instead of all this, we just recognize that the opposite reciprocal of this slope would be positive 4, so any line with a slope of 4 will satisfy the requirements. Y equals 4x plus 6, or 4x minus 1,000, it doesn't matter. If it has a slope of 4, it will intersect this line at a right angle somewhere. Some questions will require that you be a little more specific. You could be asked to find the equation of a line that is parallel to y equals 3x plus 1 and goes through the point 4, 4. Well, if it's parallel, we know it has a slope of 3, so y equals 3x plus b. Now we can plug in the coordinates for the one point we know. So 4 equals 3 times 4 plus b. And if we solve for b, we get negative 8. So the equation must be y equals 3x minus 8. We could do the same thing for perpendicular lines. Say we need to find the equation for the line that is perpendicular to y equals 1/4 x minus 2 and passes through the point negative 2, 9. Well, once again, we know we need the opposite reciprocal of the slope. That means 1/4 becomes negative 4. Y equals negative 4x plus b. We plug in the coordinates of the point we have, and 9 will equal negative 4 times negative 2 plus b. This product is 8. We subtract 8 from both sides, and b equals 1. So the equation is y equals negative 4x plus 1. None of this is too tricky, but it's important to know these rules, as these are extremely common types of questions in algebra. So let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.